elevations, grades, and clearances, and how to deal with them and what you need to know by using the Railroad Track software. Elevations, grades, clearances, and more. Hi, my name is Richard Chutt, and I hope to demonstrate in this video how to use the Railroad Track program when designing your track plan to be able to create elevations, check your grades, and check your elevations to make sure that you have smooth operation of the trains on your layout. I first started by creating a simple chart as a guide. Let's take a look.
A while back, I had created this chart that shows grades. But what is a grade? Well, a grade is a difference between one elevation and another elevation. Whether that other elevation is a rise or if it's a fall where it drops down. So in order to define what the grade is, you take the amount of rise from one elevation to the other and you divide it by the run, or in other words, the distance between the one elevation and the other, and that equals your percent of grade. In this example on this chart, I'm using 6 inches as my clearance, as you can see here on the left side, and I'm using 300 inches as my run. That gives me 2% grade, or in other words, if you used your calculator and said 6 divided by 300 is going to equal 0.02, okay? Now, if you don't know what length of run you need to have for your grade, you can take your rise and divide it by the percent grade that you would like to have, and that will tell you what length of run you need to have. But like I said, in this example, we're using 6 inches divided by our 300 inches equals 2% grade. Now you can just take and follow along on the chart where you can take your rise over here of how much you want to rise and go on across and find out, well, what length of run do you have to work with? And that will tell you what percent grade you need to have. Okay, or vice versa. If you've got your rise, you know what percent grade you want, it will then tell you what length of track you need to have. Okay, so this should make it simple and easy. But now the main question was asked of me was, how do you create a grade on the Railroad Track Planning software? So let's take a quick look at that. Here I've created a simple oval on a 4x8 table. Now there's a couple ways of creating a grade using the Railroad Track software. One thing that they tell you to do in their tutorial is to take and highlight by creating a selection box around the track that you want elevated and highlighting it. Once you have it highlighted, you go up to the top of the screen where it says grades, click on that, and then select elevate track, which will then open up this screen. Now over on the right hand side, you have these different percentage of grades that are listed over here. But notice that they're in 0.5% increments. I don't like that, for one thing, and I don't know what grade I need to have. But anyways, let's take and select, let's say, a 2% grade. Then let's also select here, they allow you to, you know, if you want the elevated track, which is what we have highlighted, if you want it to be an overpass. So let's select that. Now we need to select, well, what elevation change do we want to have? All right, so it's not really the elevation change, it's what height do I want the elevation to be for the selected track. So at this point, I'm going to take and crank this thing up to 5 inches, okay? And then I'm going to come down to the bottom corner here, and I'm going to say finalize grades. Now, if you look at your screen, you'll see these little arrows in each of these track sections. And the same thing over here on the right side. And they're all pointing this way, showing that this is going uphill to that track. This track right here that we highlighted is what is now elevated. But now let's take a look at our 3D view. If we look at the 3D view, we can see that in the back, our track is elevated, and it's an overpass because there's no terrain underneath it. But look what happened here to the front. It elevated that also. I don't want that. I want this to be at zero elevation. So that means that my grade is not steep enough when I selected 2%. So let's go back to our plan view. Now I can correct it by simply selecting these three straight tracks that are down there and then coming up to the top of the screen, select the action menu, then select change height, which then opens up this dialog box. Highlight that number that's in there and enter 0. And then say set height. Now these three tracks down here at the bottom are at 0 elevation. These three tracks at the top are at a 5-inch elevation. Well, now what grade does that give me for these tracks out here on the ends? Well, one thing we can do is, if you make sure at first, if you go up to the top to your options menu, come down and select where it says selections include grades, or you can hit F9 if you're on your computer screen, either one, or your keyboard rather. Then you can move over to one of the grades with your mouse, put your mouse right over top of any one of those track sections and double click on it. You'll notice that it highlighted only those tracks that are on a grade. Now I can go up here to the grades at the top of the screen and come down and select grade information. And in this screen, it shows me, here's my 5-inch elevation. Over here is my grade. It says 5.8% grade. Well, obviously, that is way too steep. You never really want to have more than a 3% grade maximum. Unless you're doing something like a logging camp, where you're going to be using, let's say, a Shay locomotive, you know, then you can go a little bit steeper. But for a mainline track, you really don't want to go over 2%. I allow 2.5%, and on extreme situations, I might allow, but only if my customer permits it to have a 3% grade, but I will never on a mainline track go over 3%. To me, that's just a no-no. So anyways, this is one way of creating a grade, and it did it on both sides of the loop at the same time. When I'm working with my customers and I'm creating a track plan for a customer, I don't have the luxury of being able to do just that like I did here. So I don't use this method to create an oval or to create my grades. So let's take and start from scratch. I'm going to highlight all of that track, and I'm going to just go up here to my action menu, say change height to 0, and let's put all of the track back to an elevation of 0. All right. What I might have in my situation, I may not have that track on my drawing yet that I've created, but I do have this much, and I do know that I want this track here to be at an elevation of 5 inches. So I'm going to highlight the track, go up to the action menu, say change height, and change it to my 5 inches. I can then also highlight that, then right click on it, come down here and say overpass. Now if I look at my 3D view, I can see that here's my track that's been elevated. This has all been on the right side, has all been disconnected, and this is the only part that I have left on my drawing that I'm working with. Okay, so let's go back to our plan view. Now I know I want these tracks down here to remain at 0. So that only leaves me with the rest of this track on the left-hand side to become my grade. So I can highlight all of that track, then come up at the top to my grades menu, and then instead of selecting elevate track, I'm going to select create grade. And it gives me this dialog box, which tells me, again, a 5-inch elevation. It tells me my percent grade, which is 5.8% grade. This is the best way I have found to working with grades and creating grades. I can find out what is the grade that I have. So at the moment, I'm just going to say confirm grade. Again, you will see on each of these track sections, you'll see that little arrow that's in there that's pointing which way is uphill. Okay? Now, this might be fine and dandy. Maybe a 5.8% grade is perfectly acceptable to you. That's up to you. But that also depends on what you're doing. If you're wanting to have a track that goes underneath this elevated track, then you need to have that height, or you need to have a specific height, okay? And you might have to be starting at 0, okay? So you want to lock those in at 0 and only select the track that you want to be on the grade. Well, let's say now that our 5.8% grade is no longer acceptable. Let's say that I want to have like a 2.5% grade or less, which is what I typically go for. I've only got two choices, actually three choices at this point. I can take my elevated track and I can lower it down in elevation, or I can take this track that's down here at the bottom that's at 0 and raise it up and give it some elevation to reduce the grade, or I can lengthen the length of the track that's on a grade to a longer length by extending it out further to make it longer. But obviously I can't go any longer because I'm confined to this 4x8 space. but I still need to change the grade. So I can't lengthen it. That means I have to change the elevation of either the 5-inch or bring the zero elevation track up. Well, why raise that up when that can be just right straight down on top of your table? So I can take and highlight those three tracks and say action, change height, and I'm going to drop this down to 2.5 inches. Say set height. Now, I can move my mouse over one of the grade tracks, double click on it to highlight it, go up to the grades menu, say grade information, and now it shows that I have a 2.9% grade, which means I need to lower that track even more to get me down below my 2.5% limit that I want to have. So let's just highlight that again. Action, change height. Well, let's see if by dropping it down 0.5 inch will change it enough for what I want. So I just lowered it to 2 inches. Now let's check the grade again. Grade information. It now says a 2.3% grade. Now that's within the limits that I want. It's within the limits that I want for my grade, but maybe now my elevation isn't tall enough for another track to pass underneath it. And these are kind of things that I end up having to deal with all the time. Especially when you take, like say, a track plan such as this. Okay, let me take and zoom in on this area here. This orange track that's right here, okay, that's at zero elevation where it goes under this bridge. And as you can see, it loops up and around and has to pass over itself. So all of that track is on a grade, and that grade is perfectly acceptable for what I need. And it's the same thing with this black track. It's at the same elevation as the orange track. But let's take a look at what's going on over here on this side of the bridge. At this side, both tracks are at the same elevation. You'll notice that the orange track curves upwards and has to cross over a pink, black, and over another orange track. So it needs to be at that same elevation. But when I get over here, the pink track and this track, the lower black track, have to come together at this point. All right, if I was to zoom in even more here, so you can see, I've got a curved switch here, I've got another curved switch there that connect together underneath this bridge. So that means that this pink track and this black track need to connect together. But the thing with it is at this end, this track is at 7 inches. This pink track here, which comes down through here, is at zero elevation. So this track has to go downhill. The pink track has to go uphill in order to meet and come together right here at the same elevation. So that means that this is now elevated above zero. Well, what does that do with the orange loop of track that's up here? I started off at 7 inches, which is fine, but now I have to increase my grade as I come around here because this is elevated. I still need to have 7 inches of clearance between this track and these other tracks down below. And because this is elevated, I now had to rise up to 10.5 inches. So here's a situation where I've got to play around with my grades a bit in order to be able to do this. Now, if someone was taking and drawing up this track plan and just drew everything and left all of the track at zero elevation, and just thought in your mind, well, okay, this is going to be at 7 inches because what's over there on the left side for that loop, you know, I need my 7 inches there. Well, this crosses over that. Well, that's fine. Well, this is still at zero, and this is going to cross over, so that'd be just fine at 7 inches. Without thinking about this track having to drop down and this track having to come up. Actually, this black track comes up grade also. All right, so if you went to try to build this layout without actually checking your clearances and your grades of what you need to do, you're not going to be able to build this. And I've already had that situation come up one time where somebody drew up a track plan, they went to build it, and all of a sudden they had this type of a situation and they didn't understand what was going on. And they ended up contacting me, shared with me their track plan. I ended up reconstructing their track plan, and I ended up adding my elevations and my grades of what I needed, you know, in order to have the proper clearances. And I told them, I said, yeah, there is a solution to fix your problem. And the whole situation was, you now had to take, because all of this yard track, because this from this point, this curves on around to where at this point, this elevation is at 3.5 inches. And all of this yard track, the transfer table, all of this yard tracks, the turntable, all of these mainline tracks that are here are all at a 3.5 inch elevation. I says, you need to take and raise all of that up 3.5 inches. And they're like, whoa, well, that's going to be a tremendous amount of work. Well, yeah, it is. But if you had checked all of your grades and your elevations to begin with, before you start building, you wouldn't have run into this problem and created the extra work. Now, obviously, if this is at 3.5 right here, and this pink and black track are at 0, from this point coming around this curve, that's another grade in there. I've got grades all over the place on this track plan in order to get this plan to actually work. And I don't know how I managed to do it, but I managed to get the grades to all be less than 2.6%. But I've got a large area that I can work with, so that does help. Now let's talk about elevation. In the railroad track program, and every, and I do mean every single track planning software that's out there is exactly the same as this when it comes to elevations. If you have your main level at 0 elevation and you say, I want a track to pass over that and I want it to be at 5.5 inches of height, this is how it does it. It goes from where the base point is here to the base point here and says that's 5.5 inches, which is the same as saying from the rail head here to the rail head up here is 5.5 inches. But in reality, you need to take and subtract the thickness of your track, the thickness of your roadbed, and the thickness of your plywood that you're using from that 5.5 inches, so you end up with an actual clearance of about 4 3/8 inches. That probably will not be enough for your double stacks and your auto rack cars to fit underneath there. This is why when I set my elevations, I like to go to 7 inches. That gives me almost 6 inches here, which is barely enough for your auto racks and your double stacks to fit. That's provided you're using half-inch plywood and not 3/4-inch plywood. Okay? And it also makes a difference on what track you're using as well. In some cases, again, depending upon the track that you're using, the thickness of the material of your plywood that you're using, you may end up actually having to put an 8-inch elevation to it in order to have clearance underneath it for your auto racks and your double stacks to clear it. It's always good to double check the height of your rail cars. And when I say check the height of the rail cars, I'm talking about checking it from the rail head, don't include the flange. Well, if you do include the flange, it'll give you just a little extra clearance. But just put your rail car on a table, take your tape measure, and measure to the top of the car and see what you've got. Keep in mind, if you've got the flanges sitting on the table and you're measuring from the table, you've automatically got that much clearance because your car is going to drop down that little bit. But keep in mind that that's from the rail head now to the underside of this. You want this number to be at least whatever the height of the car is. Okay, here's another thing to keep in mind. Here I've got a 4x8 table, and I've got these 12-inch pieces of straight track going right through the middle of it. I'm going to leave this straight track here on the far left end at zero. And I'm going to take the one that's at the far right end, and I'm going to change the elevation of it to 6 inches. Now I can take all of the track in between those two on the ends, and I want to make that a grade. So I'll go up to my grades menu, and I'll select create grade. And it shows me this information, where there's my 6-inch elevation, and it tells me that I have an 8.3% grade. Okay? For right now, I realize 8.3 is way too steep. But for right now, let's just confirm that grade and accept it. So now let's take a look at the 3D view of this grade. We end up with this. You see that here's my 12-inch piece over here on the right side. It's been elevated 6 inches. And this piece that's over here is still at zero, and in between is my grade. Well, you might think, well, that looks pretty good. There's a problem here. And this problem is the same exact problem. This problem does not exist just with railroad track program. This problem exists with every single track planning program that's out there. I don't care what program you have, you're going to have this same exact problem. What is the problem? Let's take and flatten out the track and look at it directly from the side. Let's also take and move over towards our end here. And let's zoom in on it a little bit. I want you to notice that here's my 12-inch piece of track that's at 6-inch elevation. Here's my grade track. What's the problem? Right there. That comes to a point. Exaggerated. It's like this. It doesn't. What you need is what is known as a vertical curve. There was actually someone who posted a video on a track planning or on a group page on Facebook. Said, why does my train keep derailing when I go up the grade, when I get to the top of the grade? What they were doing is they were running a steam engine. And with that steam engine, their grade was so steep that when the engine got to the top, because they had this exact scenario, they had an angle right here, a blunt point right there. Their train came up that grade, and the pilot wheels, literally, when the pilot wheels went past this point, they were lifted up off of the rail. It wasn't even touching the rail anymore. And then as the engine proceeded to continue to go forward, the front driver on that steam engine, because your middle drivers are blind drivers, they don't have a flange on them. But the front driver has a flange. But when the front driver got past that point, it literally lifted up off of the rail also. Now there's nothing to keep the front of the locomotive from going side to side. And when the locomotive continued to move forward and the balance point finally let it drop down, the front of the locomotive was offset and it caused a derailment and, of course, a short circuit. So what is needed is what they call a vertical curve, which means you start before you reach this apex. You start here and you start curving your track until it comes out level, so that it blends in and gives it a smooth transition from the grade to the elevated track. And it's just as bad at the other end. Let's take a look at the other end. At the other end, here's my flat track at zero elevation. Here's my angle coming in. I've got a sharp kink in here. Now, usually what happens with a steam locomotive, if you don't have a vertical curve that curves this way, okay, the pilot of your engine ends up hitting the center rail of your track and causing a short. This is why you need to have a vertical curve in here to transition from flat to your angled grade. Okay, but now that means one other thing. That means that your grade does not start right at this point. Your grade is going to start back here because you got to start the curve back here in order to meet with the same spot here. So that means you're actually starting back here. Now, when you're doing the railroad track, using the railroad track program, okay, you can take, well, let's do this. Let's take and make one little change here. Let's take and go back to our plan view, and let's say, let's take that out, and let's put in an 072 switch up there, okay? So we've got that switch there, and let's take this, and we're going to put an 072 switch down here as well. Now making sure that's at zero, making sure that's still at six, all right? So we've got those two out of there, but now notice what's going on. This track here, this first straight track over here, is now at zero elevation. This straight track on the right side is at 6-inch elevation, which means that only the track that's in the middle is what's on a grade. But this is what you really want to do, because when you're looking at this on a grade, what you need to do is take right here at that apex of the bend there, right there, you need to start your grade back here to allow for your vertical curve. All right? I would recommend having at least 6 inches of that, of a straight. So on your railroad track program, don't say that you start your grade right here where the switch is at. Add a 6-inch piece of straight track on there, at least 6 inches. You may need to have more, all right? But at least put a 6 to 12-inch piece on there and say that's where your grade's going to start, and then do the same thing at the other end. Because now when I go to check my grade here, if I highlight that and I say my grade information, it's now showing I've got a 12.5% grade. That will be your true grade after you've put in the vertical curves for your transitions. So this is something else to keep in mind when creating your grades in the program. You can create your grades and sit back and say, well, I want all of that. If I increase that and say, create the grade, that drops me down to an 8.3. Well, that's just fine and dandy. But how are you going to take and bend the curve into this switch? You're not going to. That's the purpose of using that first piece of track there as the one that's going to start the bend going down. This piece of track over here is going to start your bend coming up, your curve coming up. So in reality, these two end tracks need to be set at their proper elevations. And then take what's in between, and that will give you a more truer reading of what your actual grade should be.
Well, I hope this information has been very helpful and useful in some way to help some of you out of being able to work with your track planning software. Things to keep in mind, such as your grades, your clearances, and what you need to do to resolve the issues. So, happy railroading to everybody, have fun, and we'll catch you next time.